Hello,
I'm Jess Hamlet. Yes, that is my actual name. And I'm thrilled to be introducing Pericles for the Shakespeare 2020 project. I want to start by talking about two of the historical figures of the play, Pericles and Gower. Pericles himself was a Greek who lived from about 495 to 429 BCE and led Athens during a golden age of art and culture. However, his political strategies helped set the stage for the Peloponnesian War, which embroiled and devastated all of Greece after Pericles died. John Gower was an English poet and was friends with Chaucer, so he lived about 200 years before this play was written. The play is also partially based on a story included in one of Gower's texts, so that's a fun callback. Gower acts as a chorus in the play, introducing the action before each act and filling in gaps in the story. This is one of Shakespeare's most far-flung plays, with the action taking place in six different countries, plus on board a ship at sea. Pericles takes place in antiquity, all over the Mediterranean. The play begins in Antioch, which is in ancient Syria but modern-day Turkey. We then move to Tyre in modern-day Lebanon, Tarsus in modern-day Turkey, Pentapolis in modern-day Libya, and Ephesus and Mytilene, both in modern-day Greece. It is hard to keep track of the different locations of the play and who lives where, especially in the first half-ish of the play when the action travels so much. As you read the play, you might like to have a map handy or to keep track on a piece of paper each time the location changes. Together with The Tempest, The Winter's Tale, and Cymbeline, Pericles is part of Shakespeare's late Romance period. Pericles is a romance play, but that doesn't just mean this is a play about love. Romance is an old genre, dating at least from the 12th century in English and much older in other literary traditions. It follows a plot of union, disunion, and reunion. In romances, our hero leaves their home, experiences trial and tribulation in the wider world, and finally enjoys a restoration of order and harmony. That can be familial order, societal order, what have you. Shakespeare follows this structure to a T in Pericles. There are three things I want you to particularly look out for in this play. The first is the incest. Incest is a hot topic in early modern plays, coming up all the time. How does Shakespeare characterize the incest between Antiochus and his daughter? And what does he depict as the stakes of this relationship, both for the participants and for Pericles? The second is the passage of time. Like The Winter's Tale, there is a huge passage of time in this play, as we meet Marina at her birth and then see her again as a teenager. How does Shakespeare solve this problem of time passing for his readers, both for Marina's growing up and other parts of the play generally? What challenges does such a passage of time present for productions? Finally, I want you to keep an eye out for those pirates, or as I like to call them, surprise writs. In this play and in others, Shakespeare uses pirates to solve story problems. Also referred to by me and others as pirates ex machina, how many problems do these pirates solve? Finally, like many of his plays, Shakespeare had a collaborator for this one. Pericles is co-authored with a man named George Wilkins. Wikipedia says that Wilkins was an innkeeper by trade, but that, quote, he was also apparently involved in criminal activities. You naturally want to know more about a man like that, but the details aren't great. His inn may have been a brothel, and he may have been a pimp, and his name comes up in criminal records most often for violence against women. It's hard to reconcile our desire to hold Shakespeare as a model of human decency with his collaboration with such a nefarious character, and it also throws the treatment of Marina in this play into sharp relief. As you read Marina's part of the story, I encourage you to think about how real-life experiences might have influenced her character arc. I hope you love this wild and wacky play just as much as I do. Happy reading!